Hi, hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Underby, and welcome to Sunflower Kingdoms. It has been a long, long time since I recorded anything. Over 3 months already. I was in Asia, in Southeast Asia, and I was traveling, and I, of course, couldn't record anything. But finally, I have time, I'm home, it's a winter break, and finally I can record. I joined a small whitelisted server, completely vanilla, no forge, no spigot, nothing, just pure vanilla server. We are currently at 1.11.2 or 0.1, I think. If I take a look at the box screen, yeah, it's 0.1. Anyway, we have these new rocket boosters for Elytra. And we're going to build a lot on this server. I've set up very simple base. In the last few days I have this. This is a fish farm, automatic fish farm. I'm getting tons of saddles, two double chests of saddles. I'm getting tons of fishing rods and bows, and of course fish. some enchanting books. Don't worry, these mendings are from the villagers, not from the fish farm. I don't know if they changed a drop rate of mending books or what happened in from 1.10 to 1.11, but I'm not getting mending books anymore in a fish farm. Then there's this strange bug in UK language where some enchantments are in Russian, and also some names of villagers are in Russian. I don't know. I checked on Crowdin and everything is translated correctly, so I'm not sure what's up with that. Some random stuff. I'm using these name tags for something I will show you later. And of course pufferfish and clownfish and bottles. This is a simple chicken farm. We're getting a ton of feathers and chickens. Hi, hi. This is my simple wood farm, nothing special. I prefer spruce and dark oak wood. Spruce, I prefer big trees because it's easier to chop them down and they take up less space. Yeah, here is just like simple storage I'm using. See, this is like for drops, this is for stone, this is for wood, and also this is for spruce wood only. This is for some materials I'm going to use, some plants stuff, some more materials, resources, like, yeah, resources basically. And that's it, like, that's all I have. Whoa, that was a light for deploying. Here is a simple purple farm, and here is a simple villager farm. I'm capturing some mobs in boats. As you can see, I have tons of boats all around, and this is really useful. Let me take my Thunderbolt. This is power 5, flame, unbreaking 3 and infinity, and mending bow. I have infinite and mending on my bow because this bow was created before 1.11.1 change, because right now you can't have infinity and mending on the same time. So this one is a friend, this one is not, so we can kill a friend. Also, witch, see? Witch is a friend. this one is also a friend, this one is a friend, but this one is not. Okay, so let's kill him, like that. I have three creepers in boats, two right here and one over there. I don't know what I'm going to use them for. Oh, really? I didn't know there's a zombie villager in a baby form. Okay, we need to tag him. We need to tag him right now. I didn't know that's possible. Do we have a... No, we don't have any name tag left. Okay, I'm going to do it later. So yeah, about the villagers. Here it is. It's a villager farm. Very simple. It's producing new villagers constantly. They ignore the cap, the village cap. Basically, you just place some doors 6 blocks below the main field, and they will keep producing stuff, new villagers and stuff. Okay, so what are we going to do today? Today I'm going to show you the place for my new base. So this is really simple elytra launcher, and yes, so this is place for my new base. See these towers over there and over there? Whoa, how long is that flight boost? Come on, that was forever. So see these towers? Yeah, this is border of my new base, and I lit it up like completely. See, like torches everywhere. I clicked, come on, I clicked the rocket. Please work. No. Yeah, this is my internet. It lags. It lags a lot. We're not going to be exploring a lot. Definitely not. Anyway, this is the place for our new base. So what is the idea about this place? It's very simple. Here we're going to make a lake. Small magic lake. Have you seen a film called Warcraft? I think it was released in 2016. Really awesome. It's based on Warcraft universe, like WoW stuff, if you play that or know about that. And here is going to be a mana pool, a mana lake, same as in Warcraft, on the top of this big tower. I forgot the name, sorry. Oh, now that boost is registered. I don't know. Something strange is happening. Anyway, we are going to create... Ah, come on, stop flying! Okay, we are going to create a mana pool here. And then, all around these hills, we are going to build our base. We are going to change this entire area into Arcane Tinkerer's base. I'm going to call it like that. So in here, you are going to construct a mana pool, a lake, which is a source of magical energy. I don't know. I haven't worked out the role yet. Not role, but lore. And it's not going to be functional anyway, so it's kind of pointless. But you're going to build it, okay? Whenever I build something, I want to have a lore behind the build. Similar as in Warcraft movie, if you have seen it, it was released in 2016. I forgot the name, but there's a tower, and on top of that tower, there's a magical arcane mana lake. And this is what we are going to build here. And then, all around these hills, we're going to build our base. And our base is going to draw energy from this lake to the machines and apparatus and just contraptions all around the base. So we are going to have a lot of crystals, water flows. It's going to be amazing, and there's going to be a lot of nature in there, because this mana can only be transferred through a crystal, and this crystal needs to be embedded into some kind of naturey stuff, like logs, leaves. Yeah, that's about it. So this is what we are going to build. And today, we are going to build our first house. This is going to be like a starter house, somewhere on the top. I'm going to build it to consolidate a build style I have in mind. And I'm going to build it just to show you what it's going to be. Like, and then you can tell me if you agree with it, do you like it, can I improve it, and whatnot. So let's fly over to Hazy. I think he's not online anymore. No, he's not, but he was before. And let's grab some more granite. Yeah, you heard it right. Granite. I'm going to use a lot of granite in my builds. I need to prepare myself. I need to have a map. Or can I maybe fly without a map? Maybe. Nope. I'm taking my map. Hey, little doggy. Do you want to come with me? Nope. Nope, you're not coming. You sit here. Be a good doggy. So let's grab a map. And I need this one. Here is my base, as you can see. Here is Hazy's place. It's really huge. As you can see on the map, it's from here to over there and like that. So let's grab this. Here's a Mesa biome, if you wondered. Here is a Guardian farm. Here is really beautiful base made of floating islands. Here is also something else, but I forgot what it is. Here is a, how it's called, a swamp. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff on the server already. We also have Ender, which is XP and Ender Pearl farm, which is really, really useful. I'm going to show you how it looks and how it works later on in the series. But I've built super fast ice tunnel to there. This was the first thing I did on the server, because everybody was just walking over to the Ender, and it was really boring and it took a long time. So I've built super fast and almost automatic ice tunnel. And here we are at Hazy's storage place. Let's grab some granite. We are not grabbing everything, simply because I don't have space in my inventory. And we are also removing, how much? This is 9 and 9, that's 18. That's odd number. 4, that's odd. And then 4 here and the 2, 2. Oh, it's odd, basically. So it's 18 and 8 is 36. And yeah, we don't need this two. Like that. Simply because I don't want to have... But, okay, I want to have... multiple of 4, but now I realized I can craft everything basically as long as it's multiple of 4. No, that doesn't make sense. Oh, that's with farm, and I think, yeah, it's prepared for automatic. Last time I checked this, it was empty, but now he has a villager in here. So apparently villager will harvest this, and yeah, and then drop stuff. I guess. Interesting. Okay, anyway, let's fly back home. Can we jumpstart from this roof or something? Let's jump right over there. Oh, yeah, I mentioned it. And then fly. In which direction we should go? We should go that way. Over the hills. Yay! And off we go. Yeah, I don't like the they nerfed punch bows, but I really like this rockets. Oh, and we're skipping the night. because I can fly even when my internet is laggy. Can we craft this granite while we are flying? I think we can. We are crafting right in the middle of air. Okay, here's our base. Can I craft it before I crash down? Yes, no. Ah! I flew over here to get some more clay, because I thought there's going to be clay in a swamp. But apparently, these two patches of clay are only clay that is left in this swamp. Everything else has been dug out. So, yeah. People are also looking for clay. I have a lot of hardened clay, but I don't have clay to create bricks with. Because if you want to create bricks, you need to have clay, which you're going to smelt, and then you can create bricks. And I know, people don't like bricks, people don't like granite, but bear with me, I'm going to show you what I'm going to build, and you will see that it's not that bad. I pretty much like it. I like it. So I think that's all of it. Like, when I flew over this swamp, there wasn't any more clay left. Oh, it's over there, so there is more clay. Oh, but it's underwater, so... Yeah. Oh, I forgot I have... What is this, respiration? Or aqua affinity. Something. I have something that enables you to dig faster while you're underwater. Underwater. Yep, here we go. Hey! I need your ink sacs. Sorry, I don't want to kill animals, but if I need something, I'm going to kill them. 58 bricks. It should do. It has to do. I'm not waiting for more of them. So our main materials will be bricks. Then it's going to be polished granite. Let's take 2 stacks. Then we're going to use spruce wood, but not pure wood. Rather planks. Hi, hello. Whoops. And then we are going to use dark oak as an actual wood. Okay, I think that's all I need. Oh no, wait, I need something more. I need something for roof, but that's going to be for later time. So let's go up. Let's fly up. Can I start from? No, I can't, right? No, I can't. Where's the gate for the Nether? Oh, it's in this big building. But the thing is that the building is so huge that you can miss the portal easily. So what about this firework rockets? They don't work anymore? Okay, so where we are going to build it? We can build it right over here, or we can build it over here, but we need to do some terraforming. See, for such occasions, we need boost bow, or at least rockets with lower flight duration. Yeah, maybe we can craft this. These are flight duration 3. Do we have some more gunpowder? We have 4 gunpowder. We can use that to create rockets with flight duration 1. Yeah, it's going to be a lot easier for us. And can we like fly up? And no, we can't. We have to use elytra launcher. Yeah, I know you can use cobwebs or something. Oh snap! I almost died. Let's try that again. I didn't deploy my wings. So over here is also a nice place. Over here is a nice place. Over here is a nice place. And maybe over here, but this is not our land anymore. Yeah, come on. Rockets, please. Let's build it right over here. We are going to demolish this natural pillar anyway, like this one. So let's build our house here. I don't have a lot of dirt and stone for terraforming, so I'm just going to build a house floating in the air, and we are going to fix that later on. So here I'm going to build house on this level, and it's going to be here. So whenever I build house, I use a rule of 3, so everything should be 3 blocks apart. So let's show what I mean. So no, wait, we need bricks here. Bricks and then polished andesite. We didn't bring hardened clay, of course, because this is going to be hardened clay, don't worry. Like that, and then again 3 like that. And then another 3 in which direction? I think the right direction is this one. Yep. Don't forget to take faster route. Because it's really, really way faster. Okay. Through the ice tunnel. So this is the basic idea. 1, 2, 3, and then again 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, like that. How much is that? 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's 12, and then 5 more, that's odd number. And if we finish it like this, how does floor print looks like? I don't know. I don't know. Should we extend it a bit more? Come on, Elytra. Stop flying like that, and then three more like that. How does that look like? Yeah, much better. Because then we are going to see this house from below, because the roof is going to peek over that natural ledge. And yep, I think that's fine. I need to check my design in single player, but I think the house is wide enough and also long enough for this design to work. So let me grab some more hardened clay and let me check the design in single player. This might not look much, but it's starting to get a shape. Here is going to be a window, and we are starting to make a roof. I'm using hardened clay for scaffolding, just because I can. And let's continue with this dark oak chocolate planks. Not planks, but stairs. Oh, I ran out of them. And I need to make one more crafting table. Let's just create a bunch of them like that. 16? Yep, 16 is enough. Maybe not enough for everything, but enough for now. And we need to place the scaffolding over there, and then swing over here and continue on that side. Again, we need to make scaffolding like this. And nope, wait, wrong. Wrong block, like this. Yeah, let's see how this looks like. Oh, it's amazing. The color combination is great, I think. Like this, not really orange, but not really brown either. And then dark brown. It just fits together s nicely. And I'm going to combine that with some spruce planks, like this and like this. And then, yeah. I'm not sure how I'm going to finish that end of the roof, so let's not go that way, but I think we can go up. Let's scaffold up there and do it like this and like this. Block there. Oh, and I don't have axe with me. That's going to be painful. I need an axe. I need an axe while building. Also for that crafting table, I need that thing. Let's see how does that look like. Remove that pillar. Like that. Oh, I placed that in the wrong direction. But yeah, the roof is coming along. The roof is coming along. Let me finish the entire front side of the roof, and then we can start building the actual roof, okay? And I think this is coming along really nicely. Oh, come on, can I fly? Yes, I can fly. Let me sleep quickly. Can I fly through the portal? Yes, I can. I think that's beautiful. Of course, it's missing the roof behind it, but the front face is just amazing. So let's jump down, fly over to our base, a temporary base, of course, and let's grab some roof materials. And you've probably guessed it until now what I'm going to use it for roof, and it's going to be hay bales, yay! Oh, I don't have space for them. Like, I have space for 3 stacks. Is that enough? Can I drop something? Yeah, I think I can drop hardened clay, or I can drop polished andesite, I think. Like, I need 1 stack pr only, probably. And also, hardened clay can be dropped like that because I need it. Because I need every single hay bale I can spare. Yep, like that. And we're going to use a lot of hay bales in our build. So we need to build wheat farm ASAP, like right now. I mean, I would already build it, but I didn't want to build it off camera. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. I hate that. I hate that. I didn't deploy Elytra in on time, and then I don't have enough time to boost myself up. And here we go. Can we Land? No, we can't land. Ouch. Okay. So, the roof is made out of hay bales. That's a fact. But we need to build it behind this spruce. How does that look like? If we zoom in, yep. The front face is really beautiful. It looks beautiful from down below. And the roof isn't even finished yet. Oh, that's amazing. Okay, so what is next? Next is the edge of the roof. Here, like this part here. We need to finish this. And I think I'm going to curve it upwards to make kind of like Chinese feeling to it. I don't know, just, you know, like I'm going to curve the edge up. Oh my goodness. I decided to curve the roof upwards a bit at the end. Just two blocks up, but not a lot. Basically, hay bales are not curved upwards, just the wooden part at the end is pointing up a bit. And I also decided to add this pointy things at the end. It really reminds me of Chinese or Asian architecture in general, but it's not completely copied from that because it's using hay bales and spruce wood, and they didn't use these materials in China at any point in time. In fact, yeah, I really like this roof. Let me show you the design from the above. Wrong ender pearl. Let's ender pearl on the roof like that. Basically, this is upside down turned stair. This is a half slab. Oh, we have a floating planks there. So that stairs turned upside down. Here's a slab. Then here's also upside down turned stairs. Three slabs in the corner, and then two stairs pointing up outside or out. And that's really basic design, but it works super well when looked from far away. And with that, the roof is almost finished. I'm going to add some minor details later on, like something like a chimney. Maybe I'm going to stick some crystals out of the roof, like I will show you. I can't tell you right now. I can't describe what I have in my mind, but you will see when I build it. It's going to be beautiful. Also, the problem right now is that the roof is one straight line right now, and I want to break that line up into segments. So I'm probably going to add some ribs. I don't know if this is really a term for that, but yeah, basically a rib, something you have in your chest. I'm going to add that to a roof, so it breaks up the straight lines. And I think that's about it. Next, we are going to start decorating our house, because right now we have roof, and I've spent a lot of time building that roof, and it's really beautiful, but it's just roof. There's still a lot of to be done with the house. And there's one last thing I need to do with the roof, and it's called torching it up. For that, I'm using Danger Zone. It's made by Simply Sark, and it works only if you have Optifine or MC Patcher. I'm not sure if MC Patcher is still a thing out there, but Optifine definitely is. And see, it basically modifies your light map so that it shows where mobs can spawn and where they can't spawn. So yellow is safe from all mobs, so silverfish, blazes, and that's about it. Yeah, so this area around here is completely safe. This area here, which is like blue one or purple, is safe for most of the mobs. So skeletons, creepers, zombies, endermen, basically everything, this is spawn proof. So here, oh, we don't have a torch here, so mobs can spawn here. Oh, I don't have torches at all. So yeah, we need to light that space up. And then I can see precisely where mobs can spawn on roof. Of course, this doesn't take into account half slabs and stairs and stuff. On these blocks, mobs also can't spawn, but this light map can't take that into account. So keep that in mind. For example, here, mobs can't spawn. What is that? Did you hear that? It was like a modem. What? It was like old modem sound, dial-up modem, when they connected to the internet. Wow. I've never heard that. I need to check my resource packs. Maybe they add this instead of, I don't know, cave sounds or something. But this is crazy. I've never heard that before. Anyway, we need to light that up. And then we are partly done with the roof. I was editing this episode and I noticed two things. First thing I noticed is that it's 30 minutes long, which is way longer than I expected. So we need to finish it right now. And second thing I noticed is crappy audio quality. I'm sorry for that. I didn't know my microphone is so close. Hopefully it's not going to happen again. But yeah, sorry again. I hope you still can enjoy the video, even though the sound quality is really bad. I also noticed that this should extend to meet the roof, and then the roof should curve outwards from this main thing over there, like this main beam over here. But that's the entrance I'm thinking about. It's nothing special, just, again, roof sloped outwards or curved outwards. I need to place gray glass over here. I have glass panes, but glass panes don't connect with doors, so it doesn't really work. I need full glass blocks. And the house inside looks like this. I'm not sure about these patterns over here. Maybe I'm going to change them, maybe not. Here's a window I need to decorate. I need to put a flower pot in front of it, a windowsill, windows in there. Yeah, just random stuff I need to do. But overall, the house is quite finished. Of course, right now it's just a generic house. Whoops. So it has a hay bale roof or a thatch roof in real world. And it looks nice, but it's just a generic house. Next, we are going to change it to Arcane Tinker's house. Maybe not next episode, because I have some different plans for next episode, but definitely in a short future. Yeah, I guess. Near future. Yeah, that's the correct word. Okay, so here it is, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed this episode. The house is partly done. Of course, I need a picture for thumbnail, so let's go over here and take a picture, and that's it. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more episodes, and have a nice day.